Let's take a cervical spine pathology. Do me anyone. Not that one. That one's easy because you stretch the sternocleidomastoid massively. That's not really a pathology. That's more of a posture.
Internal decapitation, thoracic.
All right, internal decapitation. Dramatic.
Sorry, it was dedicated on our hand.
Right.
Yeah, that's what he had. That's a little beyond our PT world.
Thoracic.
That's more thoracic. So let's go.
Arthritis of the neck.
Let's just go for set joint hypertrophy in the cervical spine. Okay? So first thing, what's the bias? They feel better in flexion. We're on that. Really, the only extension bias is the dislocation. Everything else is pretty much flexion. So how do we teach cervical flexion? What would be their supine position?
Prone.
What?
I mean,
supine.
Say that. What would be
supine?
Supine.
Yeah.
Supine. Right. Sideline. We're not just naming positions. So right, supine with pillow under the hip for them a little bit of flexion. Good. But the same thing would hold true. Just like for your lumbar spine, you would teach the positional positions for the neck. So then we would decrease pain with our modalities, right? So we can use our ultrasound, our e-stim, our I don't know, did she talk about traction for facet joint hypertrophy?
Yes, she did cervical traction.
Super. Then we're gonna teach, lifting bottom mechanics doesn't matter as much. Then we're gonna get into strengthening. So there's also, just like you have core stabilizing muscles, you also have cervical stabilizing muscles. I'm gonna show you how to stretch them and how to strengthen. So that's
stretch those sub-bucks.
Yeah, we're gonna get into all that stuff. So, anyway, that's it. Let's keep going. A couple more things, and then we'll wrap it up because we're doing real well. We're going to go right to, a few more things. We're going to get into posture. That's a big part of this, the lab in the next week or so is going to be posture. Some muscles that I really want to talk to you about that are important, I think I already talked about them last quarter, and you probably remember transverse abdominis multifidus. Remember those guys?
Yes.
What do you remember about them?
Transverse abdominis,
you have the cough muscle. What's that?
You wouldn't tell us about the transverse abdominis. You said we'd learn about it next quarter.
Did I really?
Yep.
I must have been in a rush.
Your organs in
there. You said it's really cool, and it has to do with back pain.
Well, it is. So let's get into it. So you're...
Well, when
we work with our... back pain patients, we're going to address the transverse abdominis and the multifidi. They're partly your stabilizers, but there is a really cool research study that was done, and what it was, they took a bunch of people with back pain, right, and a bunch of people without back pain, and they tested their transverse abdominis and their multifidi. In patients with back pain, their transverse abdominis was a little bit delayed in firing. First muscle, Jim, you mind laying down for a second?
Wait.
If you don't mind. It's supine prone, sideline, doesn't matter. That's good. All I want you to do is just lift the brim of your hat also slightly towards the ceiling. Stop. Perfect. When he went to lift his head, guess what the first muscle that should fire is?
Abs.
Transverse abdominis. That's good. That's it. Thank you very much. The first muscle with every movement that you make that fire should be the transverse abdominis. The longer it takes the transverse abdominis to fire, the more likely you are to have back pain. Why?
Because it's not engaging the anatomical back brace.
Right. What does that matter, though?
Because it's the jelly where it's supposed to be.
Keeps you erect.
It prevents the muscles in the back from having overwork to keep you upright.
Just say
weakness or something.
I'm enjoying myself here.
Weakness.
When your transverse abdominis doesn't fire first, the motion that you make has to go through something. So what happens is more of the force of the motion goes through the ligaments, the discs, the bone, the other parts of the spine. When your transverse abdominis fires and stabilizes, it takes all the forces. So the quicker your transverse abdominis fires, the less back pain you'll have. The problem is that we as people tend to just lift stuff without firing anything. We just do this. So all of our forces are going through the ligaments of our spine, the nerves of our spine, the discs of our spine, and that's where back pain comes from. So we're going to do a whole thing on core stabilization with a focus on transverse abdominis. Kind of neat stuff, I think. I don't see the videos. So why don't we stop here right now, because we're in a really good place, I think.
What are your last ones?
Tomorrow, guys, I'll lay out the plan for the rest of the quarter. It's a pretty easy plan, though.
Yeah.
I'll lay out the whole plan. I'll give you a... I have a little...